Now is Republican Senator Rob Portman of Ohio. He serves on the Finance, Homeland Security, and Foreign Relations Committees. Super busy guy. Glad that you could join us today. Congratulations on getting that out of the subcommittee yesterday, but you're certainly not out of the woods yet. Listen to Tom Tillis, what he had to say today about the trigger issue.
Great.
I believe if we put a trigger in there that could potentially say at some point on the horizon over 10 years that your taxes will increase, then the market will not respond as favorably because you've narrowed the horizon. I think that the concern is well-intentioned, but I don't know that it's well-founded.
So that is one of the policy issues, the sticking point there on the triggers. How do you feel about that issue?
Well, first of all, I am excited it's out of the Budget Committee and the Finance Committee and heading to the floor, and I think we'll have the first vote here yet this afternoon, Dana. So it is the first step in a process that will probably take about a week to get through the United States Senate, and that's okay because we should have a full debate as we did in committee and as we have really over the past 6 years on tax reform. We've had 70 hearings. We've had three bipartisan task forces. We've gone through an extensive process to get here. On the trigger idea, that's one that some of our members have raised. They're concerned about the potential deficit impact of whatever we do. I understand that. You know, we all want to get the debt and deficit down, but we've got to be careful how we do it so it doesn't decrease economic growth, and we're still working on that.
Yeah, I know that was a sticking point. Do you think that you could get a couple of Democrats? You have Senator Manchin and Senator Heitkamp both saying they're not ruling out voting for it.
Oh, yeah. I mean, look, it's true middle-class tax cuts, no matter how you look at it. It doubles the standard deduction. It actually will take a lot of Americans who are currently paying taxes out from under the tax rolls altogether. It actually helps in terms of the child tax credit for families, doubles the child tax credit. For a family in Ohio making the median family income, which is, you know, a lot of the people I represent, it's a $2,375 on average tax cut per year. And a lot of people who are living paycheck to paycheck, that's a big deal. So I think that's popular. And then second, on the business side, we've got to do something to make our workers more competitive because other countries, because they have such low rates now compared to us, we're the highest in all the industrialized world, they're taking our jobs and our investments. So we've got to do that. And that will help middle-class families,
too. That seems to be the one that everyone agrees on the most. I also wanted to ask you about legislation you're working on. I think this is just so important. It's not getting enough attention. It's legislation to protect victims of sex trafficking. In 2016, one in six of 18,500 endangered runaways were likely sex trafficking victims, and that's according to the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children. Your legislation would remove liability protections from websites that facilitate it and allow for the prosecution of websites that violate sex trafficking laws. How did you come to actually want to do this legislation?
Yeah, well, first of all, Dana, thank you for talking about this issue and raising it. You're right, not enough people are talking about it. It is a stain on our national character that we're actually seeing an increase in trafficking in this century. And a lot of it's because of the online presence of these websites that are selling people online. I got involved because we heard about this. We did an investigation over 18 months. We looked at the websites. We found that one website called Backpage.com had about 3/4 of the commercial sex trafficking on that website. We were able through subpoenas, which we had to get through a judicial process, to find out that they actually knew that people were selling underage girls online, and yet they ran the ads. So they were culpable, and this is what the legislation is focused on, is the fact that websites like this have right now an immunity under federal law that the victims can't get their justice, and that prosecutors can't go after these kinds of websites that are selling people online knowing that they are underage. So our legislation did pass the Commerce Committee here with a unanimous vote just a few weeks ago. Today there's going to be a hearing, as I understand it, in the House Energy and Commerce Committee. I'm really excited about that. We got to get this legislation passed. It's bipartisan. It's needed right now to ensure that not one more day goes by where we have more girls and women and boys who are being trafficked online.
Children in particular. Yes, I absolutely agree. Actually, that hearing is tomorrow in the House Commerce Committee, subcommittee over there. So hopefully they get that moving. Then after you guys finish your busy week that you have ahead of you, this issue be brought up on your Senate floor.
Yeah, I hope so.
All right. Senator Rob Portman, thank you so much.
Thanks, Dana. Always been good to be on here.
Thank you. So a